My friend Lassa Sophie, she will give you a speech right now about the industry course.
وابتدي ان شاء الله وعرفنا شخصيات غيرت مكان انا معاها فلاش باك وشفت مين المهندس ومين مش مهندس وبقى هناك عرفنا طبع المصريين مستندس بوعزمين وعرفونا ازاي كده وما ننساش ابدا مس الانشراف في المناظرة الرئاسية لما اكتشفت منها عبقريات شكرا لما اثبتت انها اذكى من الضيوف وبرنامج دخلنا كل مدة وعرفنا ان كل خراب عارفين بس اللي حوالينا اللي مفيش فايدة وقفنا ثانية عند عودة الروح وشفنا مشاهير العالم بس كتير انت وعارف ان كنت هتكون
يعني صعودي بس
ولا هتكون اعمالي ولا وخلي بالك ان الكابتن لف حواليك في البعض وفكر انك كنت ظلمت حد من حد واستنى شوية عشان
الجزء الابداعي اللي عملته عز ده هو ملخص لاسماء المشروعات اللي اتعملت في ده هذه بواسطتي ان هي عملت جمل من العناوين بتاعه المشروعات فهي مش جمل ارتجاليه ولا قصد بيها شعر لكن هي دورت في 37 مشروع طلعت منهم القصيده دي فحسيت ان ده يعني درجه عاليه جدا من الابداع اللي انت قدمته شكرا يا عز شكرا جزيلا Today to be, this is the sixth year we are doing this project, and of course it has evolved along the years, and we are honored to have Dr. Naheb, our beloved dean, Dr. Shadi, Dr. Shadi for the Department of Architecture. And of course, Engineer Shaima and all the DAs. We have the XXX graduates of this 23 class about 3 years ago. Anybody from 2 years ago? This year? Okay. Everything else, everybody else is not even from here, right? مش حد خالص من الكلاس بتاع السنة اللي فاتت؟ يا عم قول لي اهو. أمال الطلبة يا هشام بتوع الكلاس ده ما كنتش ليه؟ سلموا ماشي. Okay, so I'm going to just begin by explaining why I think this is a different class of history and how the idea evolved over the time. Of course, we all know that old Confucius saying, which says, show me I remember, tell me I forget, and involve me I may understand. Okay, so the idea of having an interactive relationship with any educational material is very important. Of course, we teach our students to be creative, and this is exactly what we are telling them. The message we usually say is, I expect you to be independent, innovative, critical thinkers who will do exactly as I say. Any contradiction here? I want you to be creative, but do exactly as I say. So we're actually giving them two conflicting messages sometimes. Thank you. Well, at my time, I think this was possible. At the old age, when I was in architecture school, we all looked like this. Very disciplined, very straightforward, sitting on our desks, minding our own business. But this is version one. Well, I'm sorry, but this version is no longer in production. It's out of stock. Well, today's version of architecture students, they see us differently. Can you read, or shall I read? An instructor is a person who delights in all things wicked. He's a super villain, guru, who plans to steal their grades, surrounding them by an army of little yellow minions, but he is. An impenetrable arsenal of weapons of mass destruction, boring assignments. And war machines, projects of mass destruction. Okay? This is what they think of us. I hope not. students is that how you find them. You are explaining, but they are not with you. Or you think they are not with you. Why? Because the generation is really different. I always tell my son, how can you be doing your homework while watching the cartoons, chatting and playing game at the same time, and listening to your mom explaining the class? All at the same time, don't worry that. I'm following up. I know exactly what I'm doing. Believe me, it's happening. They can. Okay? So the fact that the new generation is multitasking, multi-interest, easily distracted and bored, they think our model is no longer in production. They can outwit and outsmart us. They know how to sneak old assignments into thinking that they are new ones. And you are no longer their source of knowledge, only just their source for grades. This is very sad. Because I think we can do a better job than this. That's how the idea of the course began. Or next. Architects got talent. You can overcome your disappointment and frustration with the design class. I teach design class. So I know the frustration that you can get in your sketch sheets form especially. When you get it on a scrap piece of paper, it's really frustrating when you get told that you're no longer good. But I think that architects do have talent. Well, it keeps going, 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 just like enjoying. What is Architects Have Got Talent? It's a new method of teaching history of architecture that is based on a new pedagogy, based on interactive cooperative planning for learning. It includes learning by using drama as a learning tool, and this is the new idea. It's now been officially recognized and published in the EU 2015 by the Architecture Innovation Association. Over the years, I've been keeping close data and statistics about how much this course is growing and what the different outcomes of it is. We began in 2010-2011 by 20 projects with 190 students, and ended up last year with 37 projects with a class roster of 219. So in total, we have over 120 projects that we have tried this method on, and over 1,000 students. So I think the results are fairly reliable. What is the task, what is the project that they're supposed to be doing? They are asked to take a character, an architect, and rather by studying by heart, they're supposed to cover these four points in a creative way. Life, influence, style, works, critique. And we do emphasize that there's a big load of the grade that goes into the critique. How? Use one of the drama styles presented. So he can select any of the drama tools that we explain sometimes, and then he goes and produces a 15-minute video in which he tries to cover all these four points. And at the end, we have a jury to cover or to judge how much we have done so. Which method? Well, choose one of these methods. There are many methods that are known in the literature, and we ask them to choose one of them. Animation is accepted, debates and trials are accepted, play building and acting roles is accepted, making a documentary is accepted, playing back to the future game and going back to the time of the architect and imagining what would he have done when on all the situations in Spain is accepted, and so on. So they can choose any of these, or they can improvise and create a new one. The time schedule is of course limited by the very limited time that we have for the course, and it begins by the pre-drama survey, and it ends up with the jury and the post-drama evaluation. The first stage is getting ready, in which we ask them to write a survey about all their presumptions and assumptions about what history is actually about, and then some warm-up activities and project outline and evaluation criteria explaining what I have just explained to you about the project. Okay, next. Then we have the character inspiration, we explain the people and the architects, follow-up and guidance, and eventually we have the event set up, the jury and the evaluation. And then the going gets tough, in which actually we start to produce the documentary or project or film that they are actually doing. hard to imagine, even for me, that by the end of this course, they have learned about 30 different architects in a matter of 13 weeks. So for anybody to remember all of these names, I think it's really inspiring. So we have now some statistics to show you. For example, the most preferred type was the animation, followed by the play building and the contests. And then we have the debates, the interviews, the experts. Of course, people like to do also the Back to the Future game into their drama. How does it work? We have a pre-drama evaluation, which in the first class, you hand out a survey and ask them, what is your assumptions and knowledge about history? How do you think the class is like? And then at the end of the class, we tell them now, has your position or assumptions changed or not? Well, does it make a difference? Well, the numbers speak for themselves. This is the degree in which 63% think that history as a subject is boring. And by the end, we have them distributed between 25% fun, 28% think it's entertaining, and 41% think it's exciting. So their whole impression about involving into a history class has changed. Then we ask them, who is the architect you remember the most? Based on other acting, based on the lecture, based on so on, and this is the results. Show us. Frank Lloyd Wright, as 47%, they will remember him. Then followed by Gaudi, Thomas Jefferson, Le Corbusier, Carl Schenker, and so on. And there is one person at the end of the exhibit.